Hello guys, so this video is to explain you about the fuel injection system which you currently see in almost all of the automobiles, whether it is a bike or car. So let's get started. So a fuel injection system has basically three units, okay? So it has three major things like which perform different functions to work as a system, like three different subsystems makes a system. So these subsystems are, first is your sensor, then actuator, and then there is a control unit. So you can relate it with your human body. So like you have multiple sensors in your sense organs in your body. Likewise, so to start with the basics, what's the main purpose of fuel injector or fuel FI system? To deliver the fuel into the engine, okay? So it cannot inject the same amount of fuel every time, right? Because injecting the same amount of fuel every time will lead to a like fluctuating RPM, because the engine load is not same every time. So based on different load conditions, you need different fuel amount. Based on your different throttle position, you need different fuel amount. So there has to be something which can calculate the amount of fuel every time. Like there has to be a system which can monitor the engine working parameters, engine loads, engine temperature and everything, and based on that inject the best amount of fuel that the engine requires, so that it delivers the maximum power, torque and everything, and also it does not pollute the environment too much. So that's why there is an increasing trend towards fuel injection system. Okay, in the BS6 systems also we have seen there is a fuel injection system in almost every motorcycles now, whether it's a 100cc, whether it's a 150cc. So let's get started, how does it work and everything. So starting with the sensors, the role of the sensors, as I explained earlier, is to monitor the engine working parameter, to monitor the engine load, temperature and different parameters, different variables that affects the performance of the engine, that affects the overall power output from the engine, okay? And based on that, provide the right amount of fuel to the engine. So different sensors are there in your fuel injection system. Some of them are your temperature sensor, your pressure sensor, your throttle position, okay, crank position, and there is a lambda sensor also. Lambda, what is that? It is also called as AKA as O2 sensor, okay? So I will tell you the positions of all these sensors. So here is your TPS, that is throttle position sensor. So the moment you twist the throttle, this flap gets actuated, okay? So suppose this is your flap, so this flap, based on your throttle twisting, it will open close, okay? And doing so allows the air to go inside the engine. So this is your TPS. Here you have TPS, okay? One is TPS here, then your pressure sensor. So this pressure sensor, what it is doing is, it is checking the engine suction. So air is entering into the engine, not forcefully, but the engine is sucking it. Engine wants that air. Why? Because of the vacuum inside the engine. When your piston is moving downwards, so there is a negative pressure generated inside the engine. So that negative pressure is pulling the air from the airbox, from the airbox to throttle body and all. So this engine is being sucked inside the engine, and different RPMs and different engine loads have different pressure values, okay? So this is a very important sensor for the FI system, because it tells the engine, sensor tells the ECU that what is the load on the engine. So based on that load, the fuel injector will calculate the amount of fuel that has to be injected. So say suppose you have your engine in a very loaded condition, like the load on the engine is higher, then at that time you need more amount of fuel to compensate for that load. So that is basically told to ECU, like the control unit is getting that information from the pressure sensor. So this pressure sensor tells about the load of the engine, okay? And this pressure sensor is like negative. So you have this vacuum here. So there is a negative pressure. So the pressure keeps on decreasing. So the less the pressure, that means the more the load on the engine. Now coming to the next sensor, which is also the very important sensor, that is the temperature sensor, which is located on the engine head. Some engines have multiple temperature sensors located on different portions of the engine, but mostly on bikes you will find a single sensor which is on the piston side, like on the lower side of the engine. So what it is doing is, it is continuously monitoring the engine head temperature. So why is that required? Yes, it is required. You might have seen there are many times cold starting problems in engines. So in carbureted engines, what there used to be a choke. So when in cold, when you try to start it, normally it will not start. So you have to pull that choke and then it will start. So basically what the choke is doing, it is providing rich mixture to your engine, right? But that rich mixture has to be manually provided to the engine by pulling the choke. But in fuel injected engines, they are smart enough to understand whether I need to start, whether my engine is in cold or hot conditions. So if the temperature sensor will detect that, okay, the temperature is very low and I need to start the engine, then for that to compensate, they will inject a little more amount of air to make the mixture rich. So this is what my temperature sensor is doing. So say at higher temperatures, you need little amount of fuel to start your engine. So it will detect, okay, the temperature is higher. So temperature is higher, so I need less amount of fuel. So this is how your fuel is being saved, and like excess fuel is somewhere used to compensate for that losses. But this is how your ECU is operating. This is how your fuel injection system is working. Like, it's a closed loop system. Closed loop system is all these three things are continuously interacting with each other. Okay, all these things are continuously interacting with each other and telling, hey, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, and the ECU is continuously changing the parameters based on the different working condition. And next, so all the things are done now. So now the mixture is being the combustion has already happened, and then now exhaust stroke begins. So what happens in exhaust stroke? Your burnt gases are released into the exhaust chamber. So this is your exhaust chamber. So now my exhaust is traveling into it. So this lambda sensor, or you can say O2 sensor, what it does, it checks the amount of oxygen into the exhaust pipe. So based on the amount of oxygen, it predicts, okay, if there is oxygen in my tailpipe, then that means my mixture is not burnt properly inside the engine. That means my mixture is rich. So I have to lower the amount of fuel by some bit. So this is how, like, this lambda sensor continuously tells the ECU about the feedback of the mixture. So it will tell whether your mixture is lean, whether your mixture is rich, whether your mixture is perfect. Okay, so this is the job of this lambda sensor. Now this is the, like, sensor and control unit communication I told you, and everything, like all the inputs from these sensors to control unit, that is affected to these actuators. Like, the resultant has to be given by these actuators, because these actuators are these injectors, solenoids, stepper motors. So what this actuator is doing, it is actually doing the job done. Okay, why I'm saying so? Because injector is the only thing that is injecting fuel into the engine. So based on all these things and calculation the control unit is doing, your injector is injecting the right amount of fuel into the engine. So for example, so if my engine temperature is 90 degrees Celsius, okay, and if my lambda value is say 1, it means my mixture is running perfect. And say if my throttle position is crank position sensor is 240 degree VDC or TDC, okay, so based on my crank position sensor, RPM is also calculated somewhere, and say I have to continue my engine RPM to be 1500. So based on all these conditions, okay, so the control unit has to decide, okay, for how much amount of time my injector, that my fuel injector will be open. Because till the amount, till the time when my fuel injector is open, that is the amount of fuel the injector is delivering. So say based on this, the calculation says I need 2 milliseconds of fuel injector operation. That means for 2 milliseconds of time, your fuel injector will be injecting fuel into the engine and then again stopping and then again starting based on the number of strokes. So continuously this process goes on and your fuel amount is added. So say your fuel injector is injecting 2 milliseconds of time period of this injector is 2 milliseconds and suddenly you pull the throttle. That means you have increased the engine load and suddenly you are demanding more power from engine. So that more power has to come from where? The engine. And that is being communicated to control unit by TPS. TPS will say, hey, there is a quick demand on my sensor. Like the sensor will tell there is a twist of throttle by this much degree. So suppose the initial position was 5 degrees and now the position is 50 degrees. So there is a change of 45 degrees. So based on my values inside the ECU, what it will do, it will change the fuel injection timing. So it will say it is 2 milliseconds, then it will convert this to, for example, 8 milliseconds. So now you can see there will be 4 times the amount of fuel now being injected into the engine. So why this 4 times the amount of fuel? Because I am demanding more power from engine and more power is going to come from more fuel. That's it. So this is the like very basic thing, very basic introduction of fuel injection system, okay? And this is basically how this whole system works, and this diagram is basically to explain this. So I hope you have got some understanding on this, and if you have any doubts, kindly write me in comments or you can mail me. Thanks.